Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off today's video, SpaceX launched yet another Falcon 9 rocket with the Starlink 4-8 mission on Monday.
Engines full power. Lift off, Starlink 4-8.
The booster which launched the mission B1058 then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage one, leg deploy.
So heard, there it is on your screen. Incredible view of the vehicle standing tall.
Orbit insertion.
And we also had Seco 1 as well as that call out right there.
There was a tweet saying, throwback to 2003, this article shows how Elon Musk and SpaceX were planning to save money by making rockets reusable. SpaceX have come a long way ever since. Musk responded with, it is taking longer than expected to make the upper stage not expendable, sigh. There was an article posted saying that SpaceX has sent over 50 Starlink terminals to Tonga to help restore communications after the volcanic eruption. There is an article posted with news of another satellite launch that SpaceX has secured. It says Space Logistics, a satellite servicing firm owned by Northrop Grumman, announced February 21st it plans to send to orbit a new servicing vehicle in 2024 on a SpaceX rocket. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. Work continues on the orbital launch mount. Another section of the fourth level of the wide bay was lifted and installed. The third corner of the fourth level was also lifted and installed. These pedestals were spotted delivered to Boca Chica. Parts for a new crane were seen delivered to Starbase. Espadre posted a tweet saying, sure would be cool to have a Starship in a public rocket garden for SpaceX fans, maybe at the entrance to the island or somewhere. Musk responded with two tweets. The first says, if South Padre and or Brownsville would like a Starship prototype, we can send one over. The second one says, maybe near BRO Airport since that serves both communities. Somebody responded with, we are ready for it and have a great location to display it at, Starship Road, where do we sign? Musk then responded to that by saying, sounds good, we will send one over. There was a barrel section potentially for a new cargo door prototype seen being moved. A new booster methane transfer tube was spotted delivered. This barrel section was seen being moved into the high bay. On Tuesday, SpaceX performed some more cryogenic testing of Ship 20. Taking a look at the Rodent Beach closures, there are some changes. Whilst there were closures scheduled for today and tomorrow, they are no longer as they've been cancelled. There are, however, additional dates that have been added with a closure scheduled this week on Friday 25th. As well as that, there are closures for next week with Monday 28th and Tuesday March 1st. Starship 22 was moved over to what people call SpaceX's rocket garden with the other prototypes after being stacked recently. Here's a cool view of SN15, Ship 16, Booster 5 and now Ship 22. Crews are continuing to work on the Ship 24 nose cone in the tent. The B6 test tank was recently moved onto the structural test stand at the propellant production site. As always, thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to Nick Antuini for being out there filming some of the content in this video too. As well, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.